Korea. Assalamualaikum, two boys and girls. How are you all today?
Fine.
Alright, now I have given you a handout on a poem, alright? So I am giving you, okay, 2 minutes for you to read, okay, to yourself before we go through the poem together. The message of the poem is something that can be derived from the story, or that can be inferred from the story, or something that, okay, this poem is trying to convey the message. Don't be sad. Why? Don't be sad. Fighting. Is there any words in the text? Okay, let us look at each paragraph. The first one, two little clouds one summer's day went flying through the sky. They went so fast, they bumped their heads and both began to cry. So you can imagine that two clouds, they bumped their heads. Okay, and then what happened? Okay, it rains. Alright, that is the, okay, visualization of the tears. Okay, their cries. Old father son look out and say, oh, never mind, my dears, I will send my little fairy folk to dry your falling tears. So, who do you think? This father son said, don't worry, okay? I will send my little fairy folk to dry your tears. So, who do you think are the fairy folks?
The rainbows.
Next, one fairy came in violet. One wore indigo in blue, green, yellow, orange and red. They made a pretty robe. Why do you think they make pretty robe? They are colorful. Can you imagine rainbows? They are of various color, multicolored. They wipe the cloud tears all away, and then from out the sky, upon a light of sunbeams made, they hung their gowns to dry. So what do rainbows do? Where can you see rainbows? They will come up, they will appear from which part? In the clouds, okay? But from the, normally from, and then from out the sky, upon a light of sunbeams made. You can see the sun shines, and at the same time, that happens normally after, okay, the rain has stopped. Is that true? So you can see the rainbow. The act of they hung their gowns to dry is actually what? The rainbow swept the rain away. Am I right? Okay. So now, the rainbows, what do they do? When we see rainbows, meaning the act is actually they are displaying themselves. Okay, they are up for display, and at the same time, the sun, okay, is shining on them, and that egg, okay, will dry up, okay, will literally dry up their gowns that previously were wet because they swept the tears away. That is literal meaning, okay. Previously, they are wet because they swept the tears away, but, okay, that is literal. Meaning physically, that is how we assume it happens. Okay, but scientifically, you know the formation of rainbow, okay, where it comes from. Okay? So if we are trying to come to the message of the poem, what would be the message of the poem? What do you see happening here? We have clouds, okay? What? Rain, yeah, we have rain, and then rainbow came, and you know, and then the sun. Okay, so what is the message? What can you relay? Okay, you have two clouds which bump their heads, and then they both cry. All right, and he's okay, and the sun offered help by sending the fairy soul. Okay, to the clouds. So what is the message? The moral of the story is what? Happy family. Help friends when they are in need. Yeah, in need. Good. Okay. We should offer help when help is needed. Right. Good. Anything else? Can we also say that whenever we have problems, do not despair. There must be a way out. Okay. There must be a solution to the problem. Okay. Or to something bad that happens to us. Right. So do not despair if we encounter any problem, because eventually there must be a solution. Despair, D-E-S-P-A-I-R. Despair means sad or disappointed. Do you get the message? Why were the fairies' gowns wet? The fairies, what did they do? Yes, okay, the fairies wiped the rain, or you can also say it in a different way, wipe the tears of the clouds. Okay, that is also acceptable. Alright, next is the tone. The tone, okay, is the emotion, the feelings throughout the poem. What is the tone of the poem? Sad. Sadness, sympathy. Alright. At the very beginning it's sad, but towards the end it's what? Is it a sad ending?
No.
No, it is a happy ending. Okay? Now, okay, number four. Give two adjectives to describe the sun. Do you still remember your adjectives? Old. You have old. What is stated in the poem? One old and the other one is father. Old and father. Old son, father son. Okay? Alright? Meaning to describe how old he is. Okay? Remember, you always find an adjective which describes a noun. So, that is found in the poem. Do not guess from the outside knowledge. Okay? Out of context. If you were one of the clouds, how would you show your appreciation to the fairies for their kindness? Other than saying thank you, what would you do? Imagine you are the clouds. What would you do to the fairies to express your appreciation? Give presents.
Give them water.
Give them water. Okay. What else? What will you do as clouds? What will you do? Take them for a walk? What will you do to express your appreciation? What will rainbows do to the clouds? What will the clouds do to the rainbow? Or you can say that next time, okay, when the rainbow is faced with problems, the clouds will come to help. Right? Okay? Yeah. That is another way to express your appreciation. Alright. When you look at the poem, you have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? We do not call them paragraphs, but we call them stanza. Okay? Alright? Look at this. So this is the first stanza. Okay? Yeah, stanza. S-T-A-N-Z-A. Okay? Stanza. So referring to the paragraphing in the poems. There are many ways to write poems. And sometimes, there are many types. Okay? So this is what we call the first stanza, second stanza, third stanza, and fourth stanza. Okay? Right. So is there any question regarding poem? So basically, what you will have for your first assessment is to read and understand the poem. And questions will be asked regarding the poem. Alright? Only one poem. Yes. Not 30 minutes. 50 minutes. 50. Sorry? Only one poem. Okay, you will have one poem and some grammar questions. So grammar questions will be based on what we have learned, like your simple past, simple present, okay? Present continuous tense, all that. Yes. Your adjectives, your adverbs, all those that you should know. Okay? Are you all clear? So what we are going to do today is to recap on our analysis. But before we do that, I would like you to sit in groups. Can you form groups? And you know, move your chairs as to form groups. Okay. Look at the first handout, alright? On the first page, you have a day in the life. You have a reading text on Robert Stanway and what he does every day. Okay? So, you have to read this text and tell me, okay, what tense is used to write his story. And then you have to fill up the table, remember, the table. Okay? And then preposition check, number two. Based on the exercise, fill in the blanks. And then on the next page, you have to choose a verb and write it in the correct form. And you also have to form questions based on the answers given question four. And for speaking practice, I will select you at random so that you will ask your friend, okay, some questions about his or her day. Alright, that will be done later. And then I would like you to move to idioms and proverbs. Okay? This is to recap what we have learned earlier. Idioms and proverbs. You have okay, 4 pages of them. And the last page, what are they like, is an exercise on adjectives. Adjectives which describe, okay, people. Okay? So I would like you to do it now in your group, and then we will discuss the answers together. But I will assign each group to tell us the answers. So this group, you are responsible for the first 2 pages about Robert Stanley. Okay? Your group, you will be responsible for idioms on this page. Okay? 2 pages. Okay? This group, you are assigned to idioms on this page. Yeah, idioms and warmers and feelings. Next page. And your group, you have to tell us the answer for adjectives. Okay? So, if you are responsible for that part, do that part first. Okay? And later, we will discuss the answers. When you have more time, move to the other exercises. Okay? Okay, boys and girls, are you all done? Alright, we will start with this group, okay? Ali's group. Can you give us the answers, Ali? Your group, can you please? He has a meeting, or you can also say he attends meeting. Okay, attends. A-T-T-E-N-D-S. Okay, yes.
He has lunch in the office. He finished his work.
He finishes.
He has dinner with his family.
Okay, he has dinner with his family. Good. Okay, so that paragraph about Robert is written in what tense? What tense is that paragraph written? Present tense. Okay, so you have to know your present tense when you write, I get up early at 6 o'clock. I have breakfast. But when you now write in pronoun he gets up. He works at 7 o'clock. He finishes work at 6. Right? Remember your tenses. Okay, next. Move on.
Number 2. Robert gets up at 6.
Okay.
He goes to work by train. He has a meeting from 11 to 12 o'clock. He has a dinner with his family. He watches television in the evening.
In the evening. Yes, good.
He takes breakfast with his wife. He takes his nap.
Number two, he?
Checks.
Good.
He meets clients in the afternoon. He sometimes writes reports. He occasionally works overtime. He gets home at about 7 o'clock.
Good. He gets home. Okay. Alright. how does he go to work good?
When he gets to work on him, whether he have one, how about the food, what does he do, what time does he
do? What time does he finish work? Okay, good. Right? So remember, when you form questions, right, you still retain, okay, the present form. What time does he usually get up? You will not say, what time does he gets up? You cannot say that because you already have does. Okay, that is your singular, okay, for, okay, your verb for the singular. What time does he usually get up? How does he go to work? You cannot say, how does he go to work? Good. Next group. Idioms and proverbs. Say it loudly so that the rest can listen. Just read your answer.
Number one. Rank or foe. Bow and arrow. Flesh and blood. Hit over kills. Wear and
tear. Wear and tear.
Use and abuse. Body and soul. Without
rhyme.
Without rhyme or reason.
Good.
Fire and water.
As black as?
As black as the ace of spades.
Yes. Do you know what is the ace of spades?
It's
cards. Yeah, you play cards, okay? You play cards, you know spades. Yeah, in black in color.
It's blind as scared of skin. Bone as brass.
Good.
As bitter as glass.
Yes.
As busy as the bees. As turning as fog.
Yes.
As brown as log.
Yes.
As quick as
Thank you. So am I. The plum had everyone in his teacher. Salima.
Can you take turns to become them? How many are they? Susie, Jen, Dana, Mei. So four of you will take turns.
Zakia's birthday party.
I am having a whale of a time here.
So am I. Glad I have everyone in his teachers.
So I hear that what Elisa, but why did she without a word?
Oh, she's known to cold shoulder people. Look, there is many. I thought she said she wasn't coming, but it looks like she's changed her mind.
I believe you look down in the dump. What's wrong?
I went for a job interview this afternoon. I thought I would do something while waiting for my HCM result. So there I was, with several other applicants for a special job at Career Pharmacy. I felt so nervous and had butterflies in my stomach while waiting for my turn. Then when it was my turn to be interviewed, I break into a cold sweat and become tongue-tied. Naturally, I didn't get the job.
It's quite common to be nervous during an interview. The next time, before you go for an interview, imagine the question. They will be asking and practice giving your answers at the front of the mirror. You tend to be confident even if you are not. Thanks, man.
Mainly there will be other jobs. Well enough talk, let's eat. I fancy some laksa.
And I'm dying for a cool drink.
And I'm dying. Next.
I really needed someone to talk to about my problems. I really needed a shoulder to cry on. They said bad things about him in secret. They talk about him behind his back. Don't worry, stay cheerful. Keep your chin up. Everything will be okay in the end. She away in the very and speaking with her news in other people's business. The woman has
a question.
Okay.
sky is blue. If it fur is black, it like to play with my mummy. Cat is follow me to school. It run to the garden and sit under the tree. When it saw a man, it said meow. Today the sound of meow is gone. It died on the road during the hot day. How good is that?
It died on the road.